What is up, guys, and welcome back to Last Humans Garage. We have another mod video. Can you believe it? Can you believe it? I guess I kind of got on the little braces kick, you know, and we got the front, which I love. And today we got the Euro Code rear tie bar we're going to be looking at and installing. And note that my front bar is Euro Sport. It's not the same brand, just for anybody that wasn't fully clear. So I specifically got this rear bar because it's a single bar. I really like the install design, which you're gonna see. Most of you guys know Bryce Jordan Production, I think it is. Yeah, and I actually watched his video to get some ideas on this and look at it a bit. So he has this part too. So let's go ahead and open these up. I'm gonna get you situated over here in a minute on the car, and we'll kind of see what we got. What we got here? Nice bar. Anything else? Oh, some swag. Some swaggy swag. From, again, quick disclaimer for Paul at Deutsch Auto Parts. I always buy from Deutsch Auto Parts except when they don't have a part I need. So this was got at BMP because I could not get it at my regular place that I like to buy from. There's a Eurocode sticker right in the bottom of that box down there. See that? It's stuck. I'll have to be careful cutting that out or I'm going to rip it. What do we got here? A nice BMP sticker. BMP tuning. Thank you for your order. Awesome. That's a nice license plate. I like the color. You know, I'm not going to put it on my car, but that's a nice plate. For real. I like that. That's a real nice green, real nice blue. Awesome. Let me get you situated with the camera over at the car here and we'll continue. All right, so I'm starting to wonder if it didn't come with directions. Gotta be real careful. I don't see any over there. I don't know if there'll be any in here, maybe, but Or else I don't have directions, but you know, I know most of it. I don't even want to use that. I'm just gonna scratch the hell out of this thing. Here we go. Oh wow, cool. Oh, it's like your weightlifting bar. Cha-ching. And you got the threaded holes, which we're gonna look at when we assemble it. A heavy bar. It feels like steel. I'm sure it is. I read the whole manual on this. I believe this is a high tensile stainless steel, better than 304 and the other very common one. I don't have the text. I'm not that kind of guy, the specs, but just trust me or go read the manual. It's super strong, so it's going to be something like right there. I like that a lot. All right. Let's open the next piece here. Okay, this is our two brackets. So we'll go here. Oh yeah, I heard these are powder coated. Doesn't really look used, yeah. I mean, they're not gonna be. That's good machining. Look at that. That's really good machining. It's a trick part that I can't wait to show you. So that's gonna go over there. And if that is, if you've never seen it, I'm sure most of you have probably seen this install somewhere before me. All right, you have these nice pins. We'll show you what that's all about. Nice pieces. Yeah, the threads are definitely fresh, so it's just a nice piece. I gotta figure out which way it's gonna go, do something like that. So these, I don't think I have directions, but I'll probably take a break in the next clip. And just to read the torque specs again, that's the only thing that I think I have it in my head, but I don't really want to guess and think with that. I just want to make sure it's right. Oh crap, look at that. Those are insane. Those are the beefiest parts I've ever seen. That is beautiful. And these nice screws here. I don't want to drop these. They're so heavy. they might chip my car. There ain't a whole lot of difference in weight, if I'm honest. All right, so yeah, we'll get started on the install right here without a cut. And then let me get you moved over to this side. And then once I do need to go get some parts, I'll do that. So you have probably guessed or you already know that these go in these handle holes, okay? So I'm gonna go into the top of the handle hole and just pry it and pop it. There's a little, oh, my bad. Lower your clip first, then you can see it real good. And then you just go up to the top. There it is. There's a little indent right at the top where you can kind of stick your screwdriver and flow it down, you expose your nut. Now these are the triple square number 8s, okay? Triple square, and they come in like kits like this. Triple square kits. A little bit different, more heavy duty kit type of thing. So that's what they look like. So I already have it staged up here. Let's go ahead and see how tight these things are. Oh, nothing, perfect. All right, my first tip, use a longer extension because this is, I got a 1.5 inch or whatever. It's a little harder to get to. All right. There's our screw. Now those screws are for 1, 2, 3, 4. Huh. I think I'm gonna use their new screw. Oh yeah, 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 of course. Cause also, it's also needs to be longer. So I was about to just say, oh, I'll use the stock screw for this. No, you do need to use theirs. So we got, see what I got, 6 washers and 6 screws. I know that two for the other bracket on top. So then these are for the main one for their product. So I'm going right here. Oh, now you gotta switch to Allen. All right. I'll have to go get an Allen bit and then we'll go put this on. So I'll be right back. All right, so it's an Allen number 6. It's an Allen 6 that I'm gonna use. And see, your two little poles are the same as the two notches. So it's a real nice touch that keeps everything from swiveling. It locks in place just like it should. So you guys can see over there probably with that widescreen lens. Pop this in. Sick. Oh my god, this is too easy. It's almost like not even a fair mod instructional video. Oh, that is insane. That is insane. Okay. We'll go over here. Ow, my knees. My knees are always sore. Always scratching my knees up. Okay, so we'll go here. Let's see. Can I get that down? Just barely. Come on, baby. Got it. Yeah, that one doesn't quite sit fully flush here. That moat 90% was me. And like all my Dynamat jobs and all that stuff. All this back here is Dynamat. All the sides, everything. There are videos on that if you don't believe me or if you want to go look at it and do it. I'm gonna make sure we're still recording. Yeah, we are. Alright. Not too bad a job, just monotonous. Okay. Go here. Go here. Seats in perfectly, no issues. Now switch to Allen. Okay, both of those are snugged. Next, one side of this is going to be reverse thread, okay? Which Bryce told me, and I saw in his video, and I probably wouldn't have even, you know, thought of that until I had, you know, figured it out. So it's nice to just know ahead of time. Loosen that nut a little bit. We're gonna find just the right tension on this thing. Put this in about halfway, so I have a lot of play. Let me see how long it is. That's like exactly half. That's pretty good. Lock that in a little, but although I'm not locking it in yet, you're not supposed to. All right, then we go the other one. See if this one is correct thread or also reverse. Also reverse? Maybe, I don't know. I thought it was like, I guess that makes sense, sorta. It's like an illusion. Whatever, as long as it works. All right, that's about halfway also. Just snug that little nut down just a little bit. Now there isn't any height difference depending on which way you go, so that's not of concern. Look at that thing is sick. All right. Oh, okay. So I already have to go, I have to wind these in further because they're not dropping down. They need to go inside the thing more. Actually, one of these is regular thread. My bad on that. Yeah, I mean, this one is turning to the right to go in, so I must not have checked that one very well. This one is the reverse side right here. I just got to get rid of that nut that keeps backing up on me. Wind it way in, and then we'll see where we're at. Oh, that's sick. That's cool. I specifically chose a straight bar rather than any cross thing. Although I almost never, in all fairness, used that seat pass through in full capacity. You just never know when you might need it. So if anything, I didn't want to drill all the nut certs that a lot of those places do. And I just like the bar that also placed low. So I could put boxes over it or something, like if I needed to, but hopefully I don't need to. I gotta expand it out a little bit. So you're just gonna be adjusting it now. I need to bring it out a little bit so the bolts all line up properly, get it all situated, torque a few bolts, and then I'll be right back. All right, guys, so I am back with the actual directions, and they are actually super good, so that's why I just wanted to give you another moment to just look at them all here. You can just read this list here. You don't need to ask me. Required tools, they have it all set here. It looks very good. Just leave that for a minute. Someone can pause. There you go. Now that you're back, same thing we did, right? You peeled off the top of the clip. We'll see where we got. And we used a number 8 triple square, as I call it, to remove the bolt. We already did that. We did install the mounts using the washers. I do have Loctite now. I remembered that, actually. And I don't usually worry about that, but, you know, I'll do it. I want to do it for this. So I'm going to put a little dab there, but I'm not going to torque that yet, and we'll see later. And then it just says turn in both ends to about a quarter of an inch gap or whatever. That's just about what I had. I'm a little bigger, but I would have had to open it up anyway to make those bolts reach. So that's just how you start it. And then we're right about here. They also want Loctite on these top going down screws for the bar. Install everything hand tight, and that's where we're going to be at next. Whoa. Okay, I have more in there than I thought. A little dab of the blue. Get this one in here. I am gonna torque these mount screw bolts only. The directions don't do it in that order, but once I have the bar up, I don't want to have to take the bar bolts out again for that torque in the end. So I'm gonna just torque these two now that I know everything fits well. Let me go here. Luckily it's like water, so I don't even have to squeeze it, really. Whoa, shoot. All right, whatever. You'll say, let's remember when he said that, when he like tries to get that bolt out someday. But we're having fun, right? Yes, we are. So the torque on these would be 12 foot-pounds, inch-pound wrench, 12 times 12, 144. So I have it set on 145. And so that's light torque. It's barely anything. Perfect. I could use a shorter extension, but I'm not worried about it. Okay. That OCD extra little push, huh? Hate that. Perfect for me, in my eyes. All right, keep this moving, keep this moving. Gotta get up here. It's already set really nicely. So I should be able to get these bolts started. So get some of this, a little bit less this time. You can't see, even see, can you? A couple little drops. Goes in easy. Damn it, come on. Lucky I have a trunk mat. All right. Go. Now they only go in by hand just a little bit. I'm hoping they just, you know, the threads might be a little fresh. Probably chase the threads before you do this if you really wanted it to turn out super easy, but you probably got to break through some of that paint on these things as I turn them in. Or powder coat is probably what it is. A little bit here. Whoa, there you go. There you go. Come on, little baby. Come on, Jack and Jan, Jack and Jan. All right, they're all started. I'll do one test pull with you right here. Make sure it turns, but I'm not gonna make you sit through all that. Let me just. Yeah, they're fine. They're just a little snug for doing it by hand. So I'll be right back. Let me get these snug down. All right, we're ready for the next steps here. So install the assembled rod and bolts. We just did that, and we just turned down the four bolts across the top here. I did dab a little blue Loctite or Permatex blue thread locker because I didn't have Loctite brand. Install hand tighten. As we said, the mounts may have to be rotated and flipped like a tie rod to get it to start, etc. We've already been there. I believe we're on number six. Yes. So now, remember, they're opposite threads, so turning it is going to have an opposite reaction. So turning it one way will shrink it, and turning it the other way will push it out. We want to rotate it to extend it and widen it, but stop turning as soon as we have resistance or it stops. And then we're going to 12 foot-pound these four on top. And there's also a preload coming. Don't worry if you're saying, is that all you do? So first, I can actually see it. When I go forward, it's pulling it in. So that's not what I want. Toward me, motorcycle, is pushing it out. It's not stopped yet. Yeah. Oh, there's an L stamped on that side to show you left-hand threads. So like, if you give it to someone else, you know, they know. All right, that's hand. I'm not going to use strength. That's right what it says, until resistance is felt. Now I am going to torque the four top ones. Do I have a smaller? I'm going to go with the smaller extension. What was that? Oh my God, that was like a Honda or something. It's a weird sounding car. All right, 145. Inch pounds. Oh geez, didn't even do anything. I mean, that's what it says, right? I mean, they gotta know. I guess it doesn't need to be tighter, I guess. Perfect. Let me get you on the other side. You haven't had a change of scenery in a while. And if you're here, you're probably just, you know, watching other videos and using this as background entertainment or something. Be drinking a little bit, having a good weekend. All right. I won't even break. I won't even take a break because this channel is just real. We tighten those. Now we're at the special preload. I can't skip a page. The preload is the important part. You're going to put a big old wrench on the bar edge. I'll show you better in a minute. And you're going to turn the bar to tighten it a quarter turn at most. It's 1/8 to 1/4 of a turn. Yeah, right there, 1/8 to 1/4. So a quarter at max, and you're forcing it out even more to make sure there's no flex, you know, sort of like that. First thing I'm gonna do is put down my seat so I have room for my wrench. So remember when I talked about the motorcycle? Now that's important. Tighten it this way. So I'm pulling the bar. Okay, you can see over here, got a nice, what is this anyway? 13/16 was the closest for me. Maybe it's metric or whatever, but this one's real good. So we got it straight up and down. I can even check it again, loosen it. Yep. So get it right about there with resistance. Okay, I'm satisfied. It's not a good turning point. So I need to come toward me still. Can I get a... Yeah, it'll be close enough. I'm gonna crank it. I might reserve a little room for just a little more. That's it, I'm not touching it. Hopefully that's it. That's everything there was. Yep. Oh, of course, the most important thing, don't forget to tighten your nuts so that thing isn't turning and freaking spinning. You gotta lock everything together with that. And this is probably a huge freaking, oh man, bigger than this. Let me go see what I got. All right, guys, so 15/16 is what I'm showing for the wrench here. Snug these up very gently. Okay. Snug up the other side here, the other lock nut. Bring you around here. Look at that service, bros. Always on my knees for you guys. All right, this one will tighten toward me too. I just don't want it to really turn anymore by accident if I start really cranking a little tighter. The install is done. At first I was thinking about the sticker, but at second I was really thinking my whole car has always had a theme of no, you know, advertising, no BS, super clean. Maybe I leave it just black instead of having just a sticker, you know. I just like OEM, old school, classic, whatever. I don't know what that means to anybody, but, you know, I'd prefer not to have a sticker. I like a raw kind of man-made looking part. This is a beautiful part. I'll show you one last time. And, you know, someday in a future video, I will tell you. How it felt, if I felt anything interesting, you know. Beautiful part, very happy with it. I will throw a link right down in the description for this one also. This was not sponsored in any way. I just bought this part. So appreciate you guys watching. The car, I can't believe I'm still getting ideas for mods after all this time. But I do feel that is also going to improve my car a little bit. I feel like I felt a difference with the front strut bar. I'm not kidding. In my quick steering reactions, I feel something different. Most of the people you talk to will say they don't. That's fine. I felt it. It was a little bit noticeable for sure. Something was just a little bit faster to respond and jump right off the line. So I think it works great. And I can't wait to combine it with that rear tie and try it again. Some ramps and stuff, not while it's wet, of course, when it dries up. And the car should be really running smooth now. All right, guys, I'll see you again. Guys, I forgot to tell you the last awesome thing. The hooks are there for your net. You can still use it. Sick, when these tools are off this thing, it'll be looking real good. Isn't that awesome?